Stars of the one thing on telly that's even bigger than Simon Cowell's face. Put your hands together for Nicole Scherzinger, Talisa and Gary Barlow. Right, let's get you a drink. I've got some Listerine.
Yeah.
Not for you, Talisa, but for you, Gary, to wash your mouth out. What was you thinking? What was you
thinking? Don't ask me that, because you know what I was thinking. I said it. I need to say right now, I wished I hadn't said it. I wish I could take it back. I apologise to Talisa on and off camera. Oh. She reckons she might forgive me in about 15 years. But, yeah, we're back on telly this weekend. I'm still on the show, but I just can't talk this weekend.
Oh, OK. Oh, have you kissed and made up?
We have.
Yeah,
oh,
it was...
had a smint.
It was, yeah, I made sure I had. I had to curry before I came on tonight, especially for Gary.
Revenge's sweet. Yeah. And do you want a beer? You quite like a beer,
yeah,
don't
a
you?
A pint.
A pint.
That's hair on your chest.
Oh, wicked. That's
special brew.
Special brew. Is that a real thing?
Yeah, and it's very special. Look at the egg on that, love. Look at that.
Look
at that. No, that's gorgeous.
I'm excited.
Oh, hey, nice.
I'm getting involved.
Yeah, you are getting involved.
Go in, you're going to get a moustache.
Just have a sip. Just have a sip of it. It's nice. It's proper stuff. Special brew.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
I can't be up.
Oh. Well, what would you want, Talisa?
I'll wait. What you got?
Well, you know what I've got. I've got a bit of Mad Dog 2020. I've got Tia Maria. 2020. Oh, lovely. I love 2020.
Oh, I do.
And you can't just have a Listerine. Do you want a 2020?
I'd like
red wine. I've got red wine.
Do you know what? I'll have one of them, yeah.
He
let's
likes
go.
The reds.
I do like the
reds. There you go. Oh, how lovely having you here
the days.
Again. Oh, there you go. Because I've got red wine. I can have a red wine chaser maybe in part four.
Okay.
Cheers. Cheers, Lisa.
Where's Louis tonight?
It's a good question. Where is Louis?
He's not mentoring. Don't be ridiculous. Does he ever do?
It's not like Louis to turn down a booking. I must be honest.
Do you know what? I might just put a tortoise and a roll neck at the end. No one will know the difference. I've got to ask you, because I watch it every week on the telly. Nicole, can we talk about your language?
What's wrong with your language?
It's like you've got Tourette's. Shaft, clunge, bold, spunk.
It's a little bit of Tourette's. You never know what I'm going to say.
I was watching it on the telly. I went into the kitchen. I could hear, God, you're full of spunk. Give me your big balls. I thought someone had put a porno on.
In America, spunk is a different thing.
It's not over here, love.
This is beautiful, you know, spunk. It's like energy, life. And then everyone was like, I can't believe you said that. But, you know, in America, balls means balls. But but there's a reason why I say that, why I'm so obsessed with balls.
Yeah.
There is a reason. The other night when Talisa and I were at the Cosmopolitan Women's Ultimate Women Awards, I got an award for fun, fearless female.
Oh,
yeah, so well, I had to give a speech. So I gave a speech, and I said, I'm just going to share with you all something that gives me inspiration through tough times, and it's this quote by the golden girl herself, Betty White.
Oh,
we know who Betty White is.
Oh, my God, hello, yeah.
And it goes like this. It says, why do people say grow some balls? Because balls are weak and sensitive. If you really want to get tough, grow a vagina. That thing really takes a pounding.
There you have it. There you have it. Do you know what? I was going to get a tattoo. tattoo this year and I just didn't know what to have written on my body. And also, another thing I've got to pick you out on. When, I don't know, how do you feel about this? Whenever one of Nicole's acts on, she starts gyrating basically her bits in your face. Like one eye you've got Rylan and the other one you've got Shaminge. How does that affect? I mean, it's quite off-putting, is it?
Do you know what? It's... my job's awful. Dread going to work.
Yeah, I bet.
There's nothing worse. Just cut it out.
He's got a minge to his left and fag ash breath to
From the moment the live show started, there has been drama and controversy, starting with Deadlock Gate and Carolyn got the boot. I mean, there hasn't been anything that controversial since Louis did it last series. Now, X Factor have banned us from showing the clip, so I'm going to have to recreate it. That, you know Deadlock Gate. There's the girl, Carolyn. Lovely Carolyn.
Lovely.
Do you remember seeing it?
Yes.
Was it? I can't make you love me like that, yeah. But better. And then suddenly there was this bloke behind Louis, wasn't there? What was it? Boat Ryland.
We don't wear earpieces, so no one can interfere with the judging panel. Yeah. But what they need to know for camera scripting is what order we're going to give our results.
That
was the only thing. They wanted to change the order. That was the only thing. Promise.
You sure?
Oh, my belt's just popped. Oh.
That's some more mad dough with that curry. Maybe you breathed over it. Sorry, I'm being rude. I'm being rude. I'm sorry. I'm watching me now, but I'm so sorry I said that. Sometimes I'm so rude. And you stormed off. What did you do?
Well, I was really upset for Carolyn because, you know, she's someone who I think she's 31, you know, she's taken me through all of her career. She's been trying, she's been no, no, no. She's had record deals, she's lost them. I know how much it meant to her to be there. Week one, she's in the sing-off with Rylan and loses. So, and I just thought, you know what, I'm so annoyed for her. I just thought, yeah. I'm not going to sit here while they do shots on my face to show how upset I am, so I just thought I'm off.
Yeah.
But I was worried. I was worried. Because I was thinking, where am I gonna go?
And I was so ready left out, I was like, yeah, get out of here.
The cameras followed me. And I got to a point, I thought, I've gone the wrong way here. The dressing room's that way. So I went, get that camera out of my face. I pushed them while they did that. I did a U-turn quick.
I like it.
In the dressing room.
Because I can't imagine you going apeshit.
Oh, I was.
Really? Do you have, like, a really angry cup of tea?
I do. I hit the desk.
Oh!
Be careful.
I mean, we all know you've got beef with Rylan. Now, is it because he survived and Carolyn left, or do you just think he's shit? No, I'm only asking. Because, you know, he's like Marmite, isn't he?
Do you know what? Rylan, people are voting for him. You know, who am I to say whether he's good or bad? But he's bad.
No!
I think people are warming up to Rylan.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for you two out there. Thank you. And holding strong. And I think that, honestly, he's starting to be everybody's guilty pleasure. Mm. They like him or not.
I think whether you love him or hate him, you still want to watch him.
I mean, he is desperate to impress you. What does he have to do for you to go, Rylan, I like it?
Yeah.
Really?
No, no, I don't.
Not even like
no.
an acoustic thing? No. Oh, because he's doing no. acoustic.
He threatened me he was going to do a ballad next week. No. I said, oh, don't go that far.
Talisa, though, don't you think? You know, it's the same with Gary. We're like, you know, Johnny Robinson last year. Mm-hmm. There is that sexual tension between him and Rylan, and I find it uncomfortable. Do you? Do you feel the spark?
I think they should just go in a room and have it out.
Maybe that is it. Maybe it's that same.
We've got to take a break there, you lot. Join us again in a couple of minutes when me and a very special surprise guest will be chatting some more with the X Factor judges, and Paloma Faith will be performing. See you in part four. Welcome back to part four. Paloma Faith will be performing in a bit, but look who's still here. It's only the blinking X Factor judges. And what's going on with Lucy Spraggan? Because the papers are saying she's quitting.
She's not quitting. That's a load of rubbish. She's not well. We are hoping that she is going to perform on the show this weekend.
She's not definitely back this weekend.
We are hoping.
Oh God, we wish her.
But we love her, and we wish her. We want her to get well. We love you, Lucy.
Yeah, send her our love. Yeah, I think she's brilliant. Lucy fancies Talisa, Jade fancied Nicole. Has Simon Cowell been on the phone telling you to les off to boost the rating?
Well, now that you bring it up.
Okay. Now, I'm not the only person who wants to speak to you tonight. I've got a very special guest who wants a word with each of you. He's filming the American X Factor right now, but we should have him live on the line from LA. Give it up for Simon Cowell, everybody. It's Alan Carr. It's Alan Carr. You're live on Chatty Man. Can you hear me, Simon? Simon? Typical. I get Simon Cowell on the show and this happens. Wait there, wait there. I must have a rusty scarf lead. Oh, here it is. Oh, it's come out. Wait there, 1 second.
Okay.
I'm so sorry about this, but I want Simon Cowell on the show. I've got to find him. Excuse me, it won't take 2 minutes.
Oh, what's this?
I think it's down here.
What's going on?
Oh, what is he doing? Oh my gosh, what's that?
Look, I need to have a word with each of you about how you've been doing this series, OK? Now, Talisa, darling, I read in the paper your dog's been pissing all over your dressing room carpet. Is that true? Is it true, Talisa? Answer me.
It did one little widdle, but it is a puppy.
Oh, OK. I used to have the same problem with Sunita, but if you get a... you get a scouring pad and a bottle of jiff, it'll go. Gary, darling, I need a word with you about Rylan.
What, darling?
I'm fed up of you slagging him off. I want you to give him a break, OK?
You sure?
Your job's on the line.
OK, I'll do it.
I want you to practice being nice about him, OK? Say after me, I love you, Rylan, and you're world class.
Hi.
Louder! Louder!
I love you.
Say it.
I love you. Rylan, you're first class.
Thank you, darling. Now, Nicole, darling, you look amazing tonight.
Hi, Simon.
Yeah. Your great hair, sexy clothes, and the tits look great. Now, you know I used to call Cheryl my little puppy dog? Well, Cheryl's gone now, and I want you to be my new puppy dog. Bark for me, Nicole, bark for me. Who's a good girl? Who's a good girl? Roll over, Nicole. Bark. Dance for me, Nicole. Dance. Don't you wish your girlfriend was here? Don't you wish your girlfriend was here? stop you there. Have you got anything else? Oh, my God, what's that?
I really wanted to speak to him as well. I'm really pissed off.
Oh, Louis, there you are. Oh, sorry, Alan, I didn't recognise you. Now, I know there's been a lot in the papers this week about my face. Yes, I have put on a few extra pounds, but don't worry, I'm on a diet now. It's called the Yucca Plan. Sunita, it's lunchtime. Delicious. Anyway, I've got to go. Have a great series and keep up the good work, darlings.
Darling, everybody! And give it up for the X Factor judges as well! That's it for tonight's show. A massive thank you to Nicki Minaj, the star for Downton Abbey, and of course,